Welcome to Executive Class. In this episode, we check out the Westin Manila, the newest five-star hotel to open in the city, and find out why it's a haven for health and wellness in the heart of the Ortigas Business District. Then we'll swing over to Soler in Entertainment City to see how the integrated resort is celebrating 10 years with a once-in-a-decade culinary festival with some of the world's most talented chefs. So join me, David Saldran, as I explore the latest events and developments in Manila's hospitality scene. The last 2 years have been a busy one for Manila's hospitality industry, and for those like us who cover the city's luxury hotel scene. Not in a long time have we seen so many new hotel brands opening simultaneously, and some existing ones relaunching. The Westin Manila is the newest five-star luxury hotel to open in the city. And although many parts of the property are still undergoing some finishing touches, it's already possible to book a stay or enjoy a meal here. So let's check out what's available already. As those my age or older would know, the Westin isn't entirely new in the country. So it's good to see one of the world's most reputable hotel brands returning to the Philippines. This time as part of the newly opened Sonata Place, an upscale mixed-use development of Robinson's Land in the heart of the Ortigas Business District. Those who might still remember the sprawling Westin property on Manila Bay will be glad to know that despite the smaller footprint of the current building in Ortigas, the property still manages to exude an urban resort feel, especially with so much greenery integrated within.
I remember the Westin, the very first Westin in Manila, and that was at the Bay. And a lot of people, I suppose, my age would remember it for one thing or another. How much of it has changed and evolved now that we're reintroducing the Westin brand in Manila?
Well, the Westin brand itself has evolved a lot in the last 20 years, from just being one of the brands under the legacy Starwood portfolio at that time to now being the signature brand for wellness and well-being.
Indeed, the Westin brand and all of its hotels around the world now describe themselves as wellness forward, and the Manila property showcases what that means exactly.
First of all, from the moment you walk in the lobby, the interior design itself has what we call biophilic elements, meaning shapes that are close to nature, that resemble nature, and are trying to take you a bit away from being in a city hotel.
The vertical garden that greets you at the entrance, the soft overhead light, the use of natural wood and stone, even a decorative patterns and choice of sculpture, they all combine to create a more natural, earthy, and yes, calming environment. Precisely what travelers need after a long flight or hours spent in a busy and crowded city.
I would imagine this whole concept came about as addressing the demand of travelers who really need it most, right?
Yes.
I mean, these are people who cross time zones, suffer from jet lag,
correct,
tend to overeat or undereat because of the wear and tear of being on the road.
Correct, and we would like to give options for the business travelers. So the healthy options are there. Going for a run with one of our recreational specialists is an option. So they are, of course, one of our main customers. So that's why we have to make sure that we focus on their needs to make sure that they can relax while they're traveling.
Those options include fitness and recreation facilities focused on health and well-being, even specialists on standby if, for example, a guest would like to go for a run. But more than anything else, well-being is found in the way the guest rooms were designed.
So this is a presidential suite on the 30th floor of the property. Yep, just like the rest of the property, it's got this biophilic vibe about it.
Biophilia is a natural human tendency to find solace in nature, something which, unfortunately, is often missing in most modern high-rise hotels. At the Westin, nature is recreated with natural textures and motifs everywhere, and uninterrupted views of the sky, and of course, lots of sunlight.
Sleep well. The key card at the Westin pretty much sums up the hotel's approach to the design of their guest rooms. Sleep well for me, however, means a calming environment, and most importantly, an extremely comfortable bed and pillows. Yep, this is comfortable.
Of course, we're very proud of our signature heavenly bed, so that ensures a good night's sleep. It's consists of 10 different elements. It's a high-tech fiber in the mattress, temperature management, motion control, as well as bed linen that is made from sustainable materials. So it's not made from cotton, but from a material called lyocell. And that is really great for a good night's sleep.
I've stayed at other Westins around the world, and I agree their beds are precisely what they call it, heavenly. But there's one other wellness feature we haven't tried yet. It's Westin's approach to food and beverage.
When fully completed, the Westin will have three restaurants, a tapas bar on the roof deck, lobby lounge downstairs, and this one, their all-day dining restaurant.
Seasonal taste is where you get a taste of how the Westin brand defines sustainable dining and hotel setting. And of course, the global brand's focus on health and well-being.
Well, aside from the healthy ingredients that we want to showcase, as we have here our hydroponic system, fresh herbs, farm-to-table salad bar concept, the fresh live cooking element of our restaurant is also part of our Eat Well program. We make sure that our restaurant is interactive in terms of guests and chefs' experience. So we showcase 90% of last minute, 90% live kitchen atmosphere here. Our vegetables has been sourced from our local farmers. Sustainable seafood is also one of our highlights here. We make sure that our suppliers will provide certification just to justify that we're really aligning to our sourcing.
Eliminating food waste is another element of the Westin philosophy. Although they do offer a buffet, most of what is available is cooked a la minute to avoid wastage, and there's a clear focus on quality over sheer quantity.
Frankly, I've never really been a big buffet person, partly for environmental reasons, for health reasons, of course, and most importantly, because I've always believed in quality over quantity anyway. And I'm glad to see that the Westin somehow agrees with me. In fact, you can do away with the buffet altogether and just order a la carte, which is maybe what I'll do.
Of course, you can order classics such as burgers here, but since the restaurant also features healthy alternatives in their Eat Well menu, yes, why not try it? So first up, organic pumpkin hummus, slow roasted in the oven, and served with pickled pumpkin and pumpkin seed crumble with lavash crackers.
So the Westin takes their zero waste initiative quite seriously. In this case, with the pumpkin, one of the organic ingredients in this dish, nothing is wasted. All parts of the vegetable are used in this dish.
Next is lox, a classic smoked salmon bagel sandwich, though they forgot the salmon. Deliberately, that is.
Okay. Right. So it's supposed to look like lox.
Like lox, exactly.
But I can see it's not salmon, right? What is it?
So it's the smoked carrots. So done similar to what the smoked salmon process is. So it's a slightly pickled, and then we smoke it to finish the dish. So that's the everything vegan lox.
It's a vegan dish, one of several vegan items on the Eat Well menu.
I think in a blind test, most people would say it tastes like lox. But even if you were to remove the blindfold and take a look at the dish, it actually looks like lox.
All right, this is like a poke bowl.
It's a poke bowl. So yeah, one of our initiatives is to promote sustainable seafood, and we use fresh tuna, locally sourced here in the Philippines, and we use it and highlight it in our tuna poke bowl. So something light alternative we use instead of using the Japanese rice is we use quinoa,
organic pumpkin, vegan lox, and now quinoa. Okay, I get it. And so far, liking how the Westin is offering an honestly healthy and sustainable alternative without any gimmickry.
So this whole locally sourced initiative isn't just great for environmental or health reasons. It's also perfect for attracting travelers to this hotel. Travelers looking for a taste of local ingredients. The mango, for example, the tuna, two of the Philippines' very famous ingredients are featured in this dish. Why travel half around the globe just to taste ingredients you can get at home, right?
Foreigners looking for a taste of local cuisine without the fattening and unhealthy stuff usually associated with it may want to try the chicken in asal, or chicken grilled with lemongrass and served with organic adlai rice. Or the pan-roasted salmon, not a local fish, but this one served with ube and kamote, two of the Philippines' most famous and yummiest root crops. There's more on the healthy menu to choose from, even a plant-based carrot cake with local coconut cream and Davao chocolate. If you're not into plant-based or even healthy food, no worries, there's always a buffet with a wide range of Filipino favorites and international classics. And yes, lots of protein. Those looking for a fine dining experience will have to wait a bit longer until the hotel's Spanish tapas restaurant and bar is completed. For now, however, you can enjoy small plates, snacks, and cocktails at the lobby lounge, as well as their unique version of traditional afternoon tea. And also worth waiting for? Well, stay tuned for when the hotel's spa opens and be among the first to experience the Westin signature wellness treatments. After the break, we move from Manila's newest hotel to open to one that's celebrating its first decade. We take you to Solaire on Manila Bay, where Michelin-starred chefs from around the world came together recently to celebrate the Integrated Resort's 10th anniversary with an unforgettable gastronomic event.